First time. I don't remember much. I know his name is Onion, and I got him to do it again because first time I was like, nah, mate, seriously, I want my money back.
Okay, full moon party, Thailand, was literally so random. Amazing. I don't remember his name.
I thought you said his name was Lars, and he's your Facebook friend, and he sends you a virtual chicken every week on Farmville.
I've nailed a lot of guys. I've been sent a lot of chickens. I don't keep a book, sweetheart.
I can confirm that, technically speaking, I'm not a virgin.
Come on, what's the story?
I've got my own methods. We can get into it if you insist, but I may need some graph paper and a medical encyclopedia.
Yeah. Why don't we come back to that another night?
So, I was on holiday, as you do, and there was this babe on the caravan site. She was a friend of my family, and she sort of ran the site. And one night in her luxury caravan, it just happened.
She ran the site? How old were you?
Just a normal age. 12.
12?
How old was she?
Old enough.
What? Like 50?
Not 50. Maybe 35?
35?
What? It was like a Mrs. Robinson thing.
Mrs. Robinson, the pedo.
And how was it for you?
It was good. Yeah. Not my best ever, but a good basic sex. She showed me the ropes.
The ropes?
Positions, techniques. Yeah. Stored all the info away like a sex squirrel. Anyway.
Well, there is nothing unusual about popping a cherry with a family friend. I actually dislodged my V-plates on my birthday when my Uncle Paolo took me to Southampton.
Yeah, I don't think we should play this game anymore.
Right, there's nothing bad about it.
I don't think I want to hear this.
He bought me a hooker for my 18th.
Oh.
What? She wasn't a munter. She was dockside fine. We're out of beer. Grizzly Details down the pub? He's with me. Guys?
Where have you been? I've got to be home by 10. Jean will be back from Zumba.
Sorry.
You look amazing. So, would it be very tacky? Or very sexy to do it on the desk. Tacky or sexy? Sexy? Tacky?
Your desk?
I think it'll hold.
I thought we were going to go for tapas.
Oh, absolutely, we're going for tapas. I want you to tell me what you thought of Bonnie versus Jermaine, the two Greers war on Newsnight Review.
Well, you know that I think that Bonnie is obviously King Greer. So.
Brilliant. The thing is, we're on a tight schedule, and I don't think they'll let us do it at the tapas place. Not after last time.
Oh, I don't know.
What about the car?
What, like dogging?
Do you like that?
No. How about the floor?
It's a good thought, but it's kind of Bernie industrial carpet. Did someone follow you?
No. What?
I'm sorry for making you stay late, but I need to talk to you due to a certain ontological confusion. Your recent work has been showing signs of what I would call, thank you, hegemonic historicism.
Yeah?
So it's very important to assist you. Phew, that was close. Still, exciting, huh?
Yeah. Pretty exciting.
I'm bored. I'm the chairman of the board. I'm a lengthy monologue. I'm living like a dog. I'm bored. I bore myself to sleep at night. I bore myself
Right, Harry. Me, you, pub tonight? Screw all these other assholes. Let's just do one, me and you.
Let's get you hooned with the hoon dog.
My metabolism has a very unique way of processing alcohol. No one has ever, or will ever, witness how we're drunk.
What's this?
It's a list.
Of what?
Of everything.
Fudge, good. Denim, good. Rollerblading, bad. You are quite a specimen, my friend.
Right, two columns, good and bad. My ultimate aim is to list all known things known to man. For instance, double Gloucester, that's good. Red Leicester, that's bad. Deep Impact, good. Armageddon, definitely bad. At first I thought Coke Zero was bad. Now I'm thinking maybe it's good. I just need more time to think about it. It's actually quite a complicated product.
Are you on the spectrum? I mean, it's exactly shit like this, which is why you need to come with me to the pub tonight for a beverage.
I suppose I could come in order to be able to categorise accurately.
Exactly. I can teach you how to become a normal, walking, talking Homo sapien.
A wolf in sheep's clothing. I'll learn all I can about the normals, and then eventually, I'll use that against them.
Exactly.
Do you want to talk about it?
Talk about what?
How you lost your virginity.
It's a true story.
Yeah, I know. It's just, you were 12. And I just wondered if maybe that's where your issues come from.
What issues?
It's just, a woman who was meant to be looking after you had sex with you. Doesn't sound great, does it?
Josie.
Caravan site. I mean, what if she still works there? I mean, don't you think it's your duty to report it?
Josie, we don't need to do anything because what I said wasn't it. She did exist, the woman, but we never actually...
Oh, so why did you say you did? Oh, blimey, oof, oh, Kingsley.
What are you thinking? Oh, you are way off the scent, sister, I can tell you that for sure.
It is nothing to be embarrassed about.
It's not what you think. But if it is, which obviously it is, you wouldn't say anything to anybody, would you? Not to the others, or your friends, or your parents.
Why would I tell my parents?
It's just because of my mum. I never really got a chance
honestly,
to...
Honestly, Kingsley, virginity's only a big deal until you lose it. I mean, I made Dave wait, like, ages, and then we did it, and I was like, is that it? I mean, even now I'm not really sure what all the fuss is about, do you know what I mean?
No.
No, God, sorry. Look, I promise I won't tell another soul.
So there must be some sort of uni health club or something. I mean, you work out, right?
No, pretty unfit.
Not from where I'm standing.
I can't do exercise because I've got severe athlete's foot. I like to think of it as the very definition of irony.
Would you excuse us, ladies? What are you doing? They don't want to hear about your fucking foot.
I'm just being myself.
Why the fuck would you want to do that? That is literally the most stupid thing I've ever heard. I'm here to teach you how to be a real person.
Or maybe I don't want to be tall.
Okay, well, don't think of it as teaching then. Think of it as a systems upgrade. From Howard XP to Howard Vista, right?
Vista had a lot of security issues. I mean...
Oh, fuck. It's Ralph. Right. Okay, here we go.
Why are you so nervous?
I'm not nervous. Shut up. Look, I'm going to go over there. You stay here.
Stay here, but... You're the one that asked me out.
Okay, come with me, but you better be mute, okay? You're my slave.
People don't have slaves anymore.
Sure they don't.
The cherimoy is a fruit that originates from which country?
Peru.
Don't know, mate.
So I was thinking of going maybe to see Ross's DJ set. You up for it?
China, India, Malaysia, or Peru?
Peru.
Was, mate. Meant to be a large one. Only Lassie, who's sorting herself for class A, has got meningitis. Which, don't get me wrong, is a tragedy, but dude, keep it real.
Well, I mean, if you need any shit, I could always pick it up for you.
For reals?
Yeah, totes, bruv. Whatever you want.
Fuck it, I'm gonna say Peru.
Correct.
Yeah, baby,
answer.
I'm a genius. Well, if you're serious, then here, we want the lot, everything on there. The ring owl is a type of what bird?
Duck. Yeah, cool. No problems.
That would be a duck.
Incorrect answer.
What the fuck?
Hi, Kingsley.
Do you mind if we just...
How are you, Kingsley?
Yeah, fine. I'm just doing a bit of reading.
Me and Oregon were just talking about society.
And how it's so sort of sexualised nowadays.
Is it?
Definitely. I mean, you look in school playgrounds, all the girls are wearing thongs, all the boys are comparing dick sizes.
Are they?
Porno on your iPhone, sex tips in your ready break.
Yeah, society's always putting pressure on people to do things, you know? People are always like, have you done this? Have you done that? I mean, I've never tried risotto. Who cares? Maybe I'm just waiting for the right risotto.
Have you been talking to Josie?
No!
Yeah, she told us.
For fuck's sake!
What? Don't worry, Kingsley. We won't tell anyone.
Where are you going?
For a walk.
Have you really never had risotto?
I'm not talking to you. Go away.
Oh, we didn't mean to.
It just happened.
He told me not to tell anyone.
And you shouldn't have told us.
Well, it just came out. Oh, bollocks. Why can't I keep a secret?
Look, we were thinking...
There is something you could do, maybe, to, like, make it up to him.
Yeah. You could always offer to, you know...
What?
Make it up to him.
Ew.
You can't feel that bad, then.
Yeah, if you felt that bad, you'd at least think about it, wouldn't you?
Would I?
I would.
Oh, God. If I betrayed a friend like that... I mean... Yeah, why not? All you have to do is put your vagina over his penis for, like, 5 seconds, and technically, he's not a virgin anymore.
Yeah. Hop on, hop off, like a city bus.
I mean, I guess it's not a completely mad idea. What?
Nothing. No. I mean, if you're up for it, you should go for it.
Right, I'm not up for it. I just want to make things okay with Kingsley. And also, I guess...
It's nice to help.
Exactly.
You're in Greenpeace and Oxfam. This is closer to home.
Well, yeah. I mean, when you think about it, it's kind of like donating your organs.
What about Dave?
How do you feel about Dave?
I mean...
Last night you blanked about 10 of his calls.
No, I didn't.
You did.
What? I'm a bit confused because me and Dave, the thing is, I mean, I was so worried about coming here because of how much I'd miss him. And he said not to worry, but now that we're away from each other, it's like, I did miss him. I have missed him a bit, but at the same time, I don't actually miss him most of the time, really, at all. In fact, I'd say sometimes I'm really, really glad that he's such a long way away.
Why don't you just talk to him?
And say what?
Call him. Tell him how you feel.
I don't want to break up with him. Sounds like maybe you should.
Really? Do you think so?
Do you?
It hadn't occurred to me, but if you think I should, then maybe I should. Do you think? It is weird. I don't know. Too weird? But if you're going to break up with your boyfriend and then offer to shag one of your housemates, that's the sort of thing you should be really sure about. I mean, that's the kind of thing you should not rush into.
5 says she does it.
Done. Wait, no. What, I totally think she's going to do it.
Oh, okay, tenner.
Done. Wait. Fuck.
Essay's due in at the end of the week, and here's an idea. Why not read it and see what you think, rather than calling up Professor Internet Explorer? Oregon, could I see you for a second, please?
I just wanted to say, sorry it's all been a bit disappointing lately. Life. But my wife's publisher is coming over for dinner tomorrow. The last thing I want to do is watch them mentally fuck each other over a Caesar salad. And you're amazing, obviously. So I hope you don't mind, but I booked us a hotel for a bit of a treat for us.
Oh. It's not Travelodge, is it?
No, not.
Oh, I've got to finish my essay tomorrow night.
Well, if you want to hand it in late, I could always give you an extension.
What?
Joke.
No, can we just keep things separate, okay? In here, you're my tutor, and there, well, you can still be my tutor because it's kind of hot, but don't mix the two things together, okay?
Totally, yeah. In here, Professor Shales, out there, Tony. And Tony don't read no essays. Tony don't worry about no prostate. Tony's the good time guy. Thank you, Oregon.
How's your essay?
Pretty good, yeah?
I wouldn't mind reading it for you, if you need a second opinion.
Nah, that's cool. It's okay. How's yours going?
Hmm? Yeah. You know they've never made this?
You...
Hmm, what?
Have you read it?
What did I just say? They've never made it. Not even a tea-time BBC cheapo. How am I supposed to read it if they can't be bothered to make it? Can you just summarise it for me a little bit?
I think you should read it. It's really good.
Oh, Vod. Just the girl I wanted to see. You know how you're a junkie?
Vod is not a junkie. God.
Whatever, like a junkie. Well, basically, I need to get my hands on all of this.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Okay. You know the cab office next to Babylon? Ask for Pat. Say I sent you.
Could you come with me? You know, it'd just be really cool for us to hang.
No chance, mate. Essay due. And this bitch is saying I've got to read the fucking book.
Wingman.
Are you pissed off with me?
No! Don't worry about it. I'll read the book. If you can read the book, I can read the book, I'll read the book. And then, I'll write the best fucking essay you ever read. Be top of the class. And then, when you ask me for help, you know what I'll say.
No.
Shh. I'm trying to read.
Sorry about Vod and Oregon finding out.
They didn't find out, did they, Josie? You told them.
They got it out of me. Anyway, I wanted to ask you, I have a proposition for you. Not proposition. You have an obstacle. You're a colleague. And I have the, natural resources available to me to facilitate a solution.
What natural resources? What are you talking about?
Sex. God, is that...
It's fine. What were you saying?
So, yeah, no biggie. Just talking about us having sex.
Yes, please. I mean, yeah, no, that could work, I don't know. I guess, or not. But, yeah. Gut reaction could work.
And I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, yeah, but Josie's got a boyfriend. But the fact is, I'm going to be breaking up with him, so I'll be, like, single and free. And you'd really be doing me the favour, because after such a long time with the same person, it would just be so great for me to get the chance to bust some moves.
Well, I mean, it just sounds like it would be a mutually useful enterprise.
Exactly. So you want to. I don't mean... I mean... You'd be interested in the deal I'm proposing.
I'm interested. I'm an interested party.
Great. So
how do we...
I guess we just put something in the diary.
Exactly.
Right?
Let's diarise this mofo.
Or we could pencil in, say, tomorrow.
Tomorrow seems feasible.
Around 8 o'clock?
Eight. It is. This is a good arrangement.
This is a good arrangement.
Okay.
In the text, words from the past. Hold down the bait to keep words fast. In reality, to come what may. Knowing what you really say, you make your life just like a play. Like I knew before would come the future.
How come you're up?
Have you ever read this?
No. Is it good?
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's kind of amazing.
Hi, Dave. It's me. Yeah, I just wanted to have a chat about something. Are you... Oh, are they? Of course. No, I didn't. That's one of the reasons why I... What? No, don't. Dave. Hello. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Dave's Nana. Happy birthday to you. Hey, Sheepy. We're drinking. You drinking?
With the rest of the ape team, I don't know. I'm a bit worried they might fashion a weapon from a bone and club me to death.
Don't take this the wrong way, but when I said you should switch to drama, I didn't think you'd actually do it.
Yeah, it was a few things. It wasn't just you.
Sure. I should apologise. I just have this effect on people. If I was an insect, I'd have warning stripes.
Yeah, and if I was a bird, I might eat you anyway.
Listen, the others are all down the bar. I'll stand you a tequila.
I meant eat you like an insect, not rude, just, yeah.
Yes, the rhythm's a rebel. Without a pause, I'm lowering my level. The hard rhymer, where you never been, I'm in. You want to...
Are you in character?
No, just don't worry about it, okay? I've got it covered.
So why am I here?
Because you're my wingman now.
How long do I have to be wingman for?
Right, it's not wingman, Howard. You're not a fucking superhero. Now go and talk to the guy. You've got nothing to lose.
Absolutely not.
Yes, boys, how can I help you?
Well, boss, could you hook us up with a cab?
Yes, mate, well, that's it.
Well, blood. We need it to Lashville. You get me?
You got a postcode?
Not a cab. A cab, yeah? To Mount Snowdon? Highest peak in the UK? Mash up. We hit to see Pat.
Violet sent us.
Through there.
Safe. Wait. There's something not right about this.
Okay, great. Let's go.
We can't. Ralph needs his stuff. Can't just you go in. I mean, you've got so much less to lose than I do.
Why'd you keep saying that?
Because it's true. Look at us. I mean, I'll probably end up being Prime Minister or something one day. I don't want to be. It's just that kind of shit happens to guys like me. But what difference does it make to you? If you get sent down, so what? You've got your Xbox. You get 3 meals a day. No offence, but I think you'd actually fit in quite well with the nonces.
How could that not be offensive?
I can't stay long. I've got to be home by 7. 7:30 at the latest.
Hello, darling.
You've got a cat?
I had a word with the provost.
You have a harp?
Oh, it's just for decoration. Come. Sit.
So, listen, I was wondering, how do you make yourself cry like that in class? It's amazing.
Well, I've had a lot of practice. So, do you want to do this?
Do I? Well, the question is, what? Because if it's backgammon, then yes. If it's a more...
I can't guarantee you won't get hurt.
Do you mean physically or in a more emotional sense? Should we, I mean, because different species maybe shouldn't, or maybe it's okay.
Wow. Wowee.
Yeah.
Oh, do I just take it off, yeah? Obviously. What time is it?
Got somewhere you need to be.
Sorry, I just don't want to be late. I'm not.
Wow.
No, I said I'd be home by 7:30. Is that bad?
Okay. First, you've never used a condom before, naughty boy. Now you're at the door like a bullet.
It's not like that. Really. I've had an amazing time. Cuddle?
No, don't spoil it.
Was it all okay?
It worked.
God, I've had such an amazing... I'm so sorry. Can I call you?
No, go on, out.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. Meh.
Mission accomplished. So, should we get the pre-lash going with a little bit of cha-cha-cha-ching?
Love to, Peony. We better get going.
Cool.
There may be a problem. Train is mofo.
Well, couldn't you maybe just lend me something of yours?
Sorry, dude, mine's all custom-made. It would be like lending you my fountain pen or something.
Yeah, Howard, lend me your shoes.
No.
A good wingman will always relinquish his shoes.
No.
You kids have fun, yeah? Make yourselves at home. Bridget will show you where everything is. Won't you, Bridget?
Fuck you.
Come on, Howard. Just get your stuff together.
I don't have any stuff.
Can we just go?
But we've got so much more to discuss. We're not even close to a decision on France.
Or chess.
Or...
kettle chips.
I love kale
chips. A new flavour, actually.
How do you like it, Mrs. Brown?
I love it, Mr. Brown.
Mm-hmm. This is more like it, right?
Yeah. And I finished my essay, so we've got all the time in the world.
Yeah, well, tell Professor Shales about the essay. Tony's all about the poontang.
Yeah. It's about the absence of femininity. You know, there's not one single woman in the whole book.
Brilliant. You managed to finish it? Beverage?
Yes, please. Why the face?
What face? Gin and tonic, okay?
Yes, please. When I said about the absence of femininity...
Oh, it's a good angle.
But?
I've seen a lot of undergraduate Susan Sontag impressions. That's all. Anyway, let's keep things separate. Yep.
Whose is the shopping?
Oh, it's mine. There's a really big Asda, so I thought mini bar prices and all that. Cheers.
Cheers. So what's the breakfast like? I love the tiny jams.
I don't know, but go crazy. Have mine. I mean, I think it's buffet style, but...
Why can't I have yours?
Oh, I can't stay. I've got ice cream in the shopping. I said I was at the pub quiz, so 11 at the latest.
You're leaving me here?
It'll be fun, the night in the hotel. What?
You said you booked something special. This isn't special, this is just seedy. You might as well have booked a motel and paid me by the hour.
Oh, don't be like that.
Why have you got a boner?
I haven't got a boner.
I'm upset and we're having an argument and you've got a boner.
I haven't got a boner. It's just the way my trousers. Look. All right. I find you exciting. I find this exciting. I'm sorry, I can't help it. But we don't have to do stuff. We can just chat. It's not seedy if we chat, is it?
You want to chat?
Of course I do. Look, this isn't all just about, you know, for me. This is about you as a person. Come on. I want to talk more about you, about your time in Cambodia.
Thailand.
The Israeli guy could roll the really enormous joints. That was funny.
Yes. He was quite fun.
Oh, God. So good. God, that was good. Good girl. Good girl.
Oh, I'm telling you, this essay is probably going to fucking revolutionise the entire history of fucking history. I mean, I can't believe how fun it is writing an essay when you've read the book.
Glad you enjoyed it.
Well, you're back early.
Yeah, kind of shit night in the end.
Oh, mate, I'd love to hear all about it, but I've got another 1,000 words to go.
How's it going, Kingsley?
Doing something?
Nothing special.
Glass of milk? Good idea. Good for you. Keep your strength up.
Strengthens the bones.
Come in.
Music. I didn't know about music. I did candles because I thought, yeah, I can't go wrong with candles. Come in. But music's one of those personal taste things, isn't it? Like, you know, Dave likes to do it to a beat. Sit down. But then maybe that's a bit too much. And also, here, I didn't know what kind of beat you'd want. I mean, if you have a heavy beat, that might feel like too much pressure. But then if you don't have any beat and it's something soft, I mean, is that just too cheesy? And what if the lyrics are really embarrassing? But then if you have no music and it's all just quiet and all you can hear are the sounds, because sometimes when I get nervous, I get a dry mouth and I start making this, like, clacking sound, like a kind of, like a kind of... So, what I was thinking was, if we could just get under the covers and start from there.
Listen, Josie.
You've changed your mind. Is it the candles? It's too much, isn't it?
No, it's not that.
It's just, you look better in candlelight, don't you? In case, you know, you saw me and decided that you didn't fancy me.
Josie, I fancy you. I mean, not actually fancy, obviously. It's not going to get complicated. But I can look at you and understand how a generic person could fancy you.
The main thing is, you did it.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't think it doesn't count just because you didn't...
No?
No. No, that's quite normal, I think. First time round. I mean, you got it in. And that is the main thing.
It does work. Normally. Just because I... When I do it myself sort of thing.
That's good.
I just think under the pressure probably of the situation, it didn't want to actually give forth.
Hmm.
I did enjoy myself, though.
Yeah. Yeah.
What about you?
Me?
Was it weird? First time after splitting up with Dave?
Yeah. Yes and no. Ish. The main thing for you is, though, you came in this room a virgin and you're leaving it not a virgin. So how does that make you feel?
Feels... yeah. Really brilliant. Anyway, thank you. Thank you very much.
It's nothing. Quite all right. Thank you.
Ah! Yay! Yay! Cherry pie. Come on.
What's happening? Are you guys having a party without me? Fuck's sake, guys. The other day, when I asked whether someone wanted to come to the pub with me, none of you could be bothered. Am I just the posh idiot that you all secretly hate?
Of course not, Bob. We just thought you were out. Kingsley just lost his virginity like 5 seconds ago.
But I thought...
Yeah, the story about the pedo? Bullshit!
It wasn't a pedo story. You were a virgin. Whoa, sorry. The pussy man was a virgin.
Valiant effort, especially considering your apparent phobia of spell checking. Well done, Oregon. Great work. Very original.
Oh, wow. Well done.
Vod, your opening salvo was certainly impressive. I read this book.
Yeah, I did. I read the whole thing.
I really loved it. It was fucking brilliant. Oh, I know you read it. You make repeated references to you experiencing reading it. This isn't an online blog, Miss Nordstrom. This is a literature class, and we expect you to at least engage some of your critical faculties. Do you know what those are?
Yeah.
Well then, fucking well use them.
He's a critical faculty. What a fucking cunt, do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Can't get enough of fresh meat? Get a second helping on Twitter now with co-writer Sam Bain, plus Sarway and Greg, the actors behind Vod and Howard, are waiting for you. To take part, just send in your questions and comments to comedy on 4. It's the one about the priest next tonight in Shameless.